business prospers through tight work cycles and a focus on driving value. But developers are typically committed to long-term project roadmaps. That's where low-code software development comes in. Think of low-code as filling a gap between business and traditional development. Low-code is a visual and largely automated approach to software development. Tasks are defined at a high level, then tools generate most of the underlying code base. Low-code can deal with many everyday programming chores, freeing developer teams to focus on bigger, more complex projects. Low-code allows for more rapid software development because it reuses both code and modules. Not only does it cut costs in terms of money and time, but also requires less specialized programming expertise. Here, we'll dig into what low-code is, how it can be used in the enterprise, and the pros and cons associated. First, let's talk about how conventional coding works. Typically, software developers write individual lines of code to represent instructions and data. Then they organize the code into functional routines and modules. This requires a lot of detailed knowledge about coding languages, development environments, testing, and deployment tools. Plus, the developer needs to be on top of current policies and practices used to code, test, and deploy. But low-code technology abstracts and encapsulates a lot of the programming knowledge needed to create software. So instead of writing individual lines of code, users select from a menu of reusable functional components using a drag-and-drop visual interface. Users can then add or delete components or move them around to create the intended software flow. The low-code tool accounts for underlying code and support tasks like testing and deployment. Some see no-code systems as a subset of low-code platforms, but they're not the same. Low-code doesn't eliminate coding. Many low-code projects require some programming, either to modify existing functional components or create new ones. But no-code does aim to eliminate any need for coding. No-code systems provide all features and functions with no need to add or alter components. With no-code, users don't need to know anything about programming or app design. So even though low-code is nothing like traditional software that might require thousands, maybe tens of thousands of lines of code, a low-code project still involves some coding. There's plenty of opportunity for low-code projects, particularly for an enterprise's developer team. Low-code apps can be used to create web portals, set up line-of-business systems to conduct everyday tasks, digitize paper or spreadsheet-based business processes, build mobile apps for customers to access information or conduct business interactions, develop microservices-based applications, or integrate IoT endpoints and collect valuable data. Low-code can also be useful in a variety of sectors that touch our lives every day. One example is educational institutions with their fluctuating enrollments, evolving educational strategies, and demands for hybrid and remote learning. Low-code can help with enrollment management platforms, learning management systems, or building or rebuilding applications needed to measure learning outcomes even as variables change. And during the recent COVID-19 pandemic, some schools used template-based websites to disseminate changing COVID-19 information to faculty, parents, and students. Then there's healthcare facilities, which need to communicate with patients while meeting some stringent security requirements. With low-code, developers can build customer-facing apps for patients to access their records and other information. It can also help simplify compliance requirements by generating code designed to conform to HIPAA regulations right out of the box. As in the healthcare field, the financial services sector also needs to follow stringent security requirements while also helping customers access essential information. So in financial institutions, developers can use low-code to build UIs that tie into complex or legacy back-end systems. Low-code development also helps financial institutions update customer apps more easily. Let's get into the pros and cons. In addition to delivering products and features faster and for less cost, low-code boasts many benefits. Low-code is an advantage when your developer team is understaffed. Most companies have dealt with a shortage of developer talent. With low-code, staff will need to write less code. Plus, the visual drag-and-drop interface of low-code lets anyone, developers and non-developers alike, delineate high-level ideas. The customizability of low-code software makes the approach appealing too. Individuals or departments can create, essentially, their own applications to meet highly specific and unique needs or timelines, often with little or no direct work from the core software team. And a low-code platform, which can impose standards and track code, provides a common and auditable environment. A low-code platform can also boost application analytics and lifecycle support. Users can gather data for the business and development team, which teams compare one app's performance against other in-house apps. There are security advantages to low-code as well. Low-code platforms can reduce risks caused by unsanctioned or rogue programming like shadow IT. Not to say that a business should stop using conventional development. There are complex or specialized software projects that still require the traditional approach. Despite the benefits of low-code software, it's important to be wary of a few things. First, you shouldn't assume that low-code eliminates the need for skilled staff. If individuals without programming knowledge take on an enterprise-level programming task, their companies could end up spending a lot to fix bad code. And while low-code platforms can solve some business programming problems quite well, it can't solve all of them. With complex tasks, it may be smarter to go the conventional software development route, which again highlights the need for coding skills on developer teams. It's always important for someone in the organization to have a comprehensive knowledge of what's going on under the hood of a low-code platform. If low-code's resulting code functions work as expected, great. But if it doesn't, someone must be able to diagnose the cause of underperformance or errors. Likewise, a comprehensive understanding of what's inside any low-code app is essential for companies to make sure standards for security and compliance are enforced. The marketplace for low-code tools and platforms is still evolving. There are vendors who combine both low-code and no-code functions in their product. There are also various cloud-native options as well as third-party low-code products and platforms. We're talking anything from simple website and mobile apps to enterprise-class application development. Anyone interested in low-code should focus on evaluating a given low-code platform's specific capabilities. Pay particular attention to how the low-code platform handles components. For example, make sure the tool's packaged modules and components closely map to the high-level building blocks and functional methodologies that your organization already uses. If it does, you'll need fewer changes or new custom components. If you think your organization will still need to develop new components, evaluate the ease and efficiency of the customization engine in creating new visual blocks or custom code. It's clear the future for low-code development and platforms is one that will continue to build on the trends and behaviors set in place in 2020. The COVID-19 global pandemic put a big strain on development budgets, staff availability, and on teams in general. As employees switched almost overnight to remote work, organizations were forced to develop apps, portals, web forms, and automated workflows fast. you'll definitely see an expansion on all those fronts. In 2020, low-code and no-code made up under 25% of app development. Gartner is now projecting that that will climb to 75% by 2025. One thing you need to know about low-code is this. Your developer team needs to embrace low-code now. Learn now how low-code platforms work to extend and customize low-code components. This requires good communication and collaboration skills. Developer teams need to work well with both business personnel and non-IT employees in order to plan for and create the enterprise applications of the future with low-code.